call centers are the places where people that get deported go because they use their language. You know, it's all English. We speak nothing but English there. Hi, this is John from Smart Energy Advocates. Our reason for our call is because we're helping the homeowners in your area to reduce their electricity bills. My name is Raul Barocio Mendoza. I was deported in April of 2004, indefinitely. I was a legal resident. I thought I was American. I didn't think that I could be deported. I had no idea. So I lived with that thought in my head. And when I got here, yeah, I was shocked.
La águila con los nopales allí abajo es pues que soy mexicano.
El sur
es Southern United Raza, que significa pues, la raza unida del sur de California. Los otros tatuajes me los estaba poniendo conforme el tiempo que va pasando uno en la prisión. Quisiera quitármelos, la verdad. Yo me acuerdo cuando mis hijos, la Karen y el Raulito, cuando estaban chiquitos, agarraban borradores y querían borrármelos. Les digo, no se borran. No se borra. Así es.
When I first got here to TJ, I worked in a call center because it was the only place that opened their doors to me. Del Oro offered me an opportunity also, and I jumped on board with them, been with them for 3 years, and I would say at least 99% of the people working there are deportees, you know.
I was deported approximately like 8 years ago. I was in the Marine Corps. I'm a veteran. Right now I'm here in Mexico, trying to get back to the States.
I was deported because of minor crimes. I had so many of them that I finally got deported. I've been in this call center for about 3 weeks, and I've been working call centers here since 6 years ago. And yes, I would like to go back, I mean, definitely.
I've been deported from United States because it's an aggravated assault. I prefer living in the United States, you know. It's hard here, real hard, but you know.
Bueno, resulta complicado estimar el número de personas deportadas que trabajan en call center, porque a su vez resulta complicado estimar el número de personas total que trabaja en call center. Son varios cientos de miles y probablemente andan en ese rango de 300-350 mil. En lo relacionado con call center, estudiamos trabajadores ubicados en Monterrey, en la Ciudad de México y en Tijuana. En el transcurso de la investigación nos dimos cuenta de que en los call centers, sobre todo de Tijuana y Monterrey, una parte del personal empleado eran personas deportadas de los Estados Unidos.
Well, telemarketing is a great way of getting through to people, especially homeowners. It's disruptive marketing. TJ has really the right business environment for having a call center. It has a huge influx of folks who are being deported right now from the U.S. And what we get are folks who are bilingual, but more importantly, I think, bicultural.
So this is Before I Die, I Want. And what it does is it talks about purpose. Some people want something physical, like a Jeep Patriot. Some people want to travel, go to Italy, want to be a good dad. Some people treat it very casually, some people are very serious about it. But I think it strikes at the underpinnings of who we are, which is you have to have a purpose.
I think about 2/3 to 75% of the people who are deported are deported for minor violations, like running a stop sign or a stoplight. So even though they have had involvement with law enforcement, they're not violent criminals. They're more caught up in a political process that maybe in the past wouldn't have had them deported, but now does. I see their situation being out of their control, and that they have to start their lives over again, and they need an opportunity.
Sabemos, sí, más o menos las cifras de deportados, ¿no? En Tijuana se calcula que a final de año pueden ser 60,000, pero evidentemente solo una pequeña parte de esa gran cantidad de deportados probablemente tenga los requisitos, digamos, que piden los call centers.
The entry-level salary is very competitive, but it's not meant to sustain someone forever. We have folks that come in and start at, I don't know, maybe 1,400 pesos a week. That's a base salary. And then we have folks that have worked their way up and make more than 20,000 pesos a week. That's how we approach pay.
Thank you, Johnny. Jackpot, Mr. Frankie Macera.
Every time they get a sale or they hit a jackpot, that's when the bell goes off. Only jackpots. They get paid 50 pesos for their commissions, and they get 15 pesos on top of that. That's for today's motivational game.
All these guys are gonna be walking out of here with all these chips home.
Everybody goes home with money in their pockets at the end of the day right here at El Oro.
Padre mío, gracias te damos por habernos permitido estar aquí reunidos en tu nombre, Señor. Bendícenos, Señor, y nos despedimos, Señor, en tu nombre, en el nombre de Jesucristo. Amén.
It's very important for me to attend the classes I attend in church on Sundays. We leave early in the morning. It's not just on Sundays that I go to church, but it's pretty much my lifestyle that I have now.
La vida en Cristo es bien suave. ¿Cuántos dicen amén?
Amén.
El vivir en Cristo no es para viejitos. Amén. Es para viejitos, para chiquitos, para grandotes, para jóvenes. El Señor es para todos. Para que el hombre tenga fe. Si algo necesita el hombre en este tiempo es fe.
The first crime why I was incarcerated was for possession of cocaine. In 1992 was my first time I was deported. I went back and I was still doing the same things, using the drugs, and I got caught up again and got arrested for hanging out with the wrong crowd, and went to prison. This time it was for 97 months. Ended up here in Mexico again in April of 2004, and I've been here ever since then.
Llegué aquí a México en abril del 2004. Raúl y yo nos conocimos durante el tiempo que estuvimos detenidos en una prisión federal. Yo llegué aquí a Tijuana dos semanas antes de que llegara él. En mi caso, igual que en el caso de Raúl, nosotros a nuestras familias nos llevaron para allá, para el otro lado cuando éramos pequeños. Entonces nosotros ya habíamos, de cierta manera, nosotros ya habíamos adaptado a otra cultura. Nosotros crecimos en otra cultura. Entonces cuando venimos aquí, estábamos en una cultura totalmente desconocida, pero gracias a Dios estoy aquí todavía, ¿verdad? Pero gracias a Dios que no me perdí en ese grupo que anda durmiendo adentro del canal, ¿no?
En Tijuana, en Tamaulipas, en Ciudad Juárez, no hay muchas oportunidades de empleo, lo cual hace más grave la situación para los deportados y para las ciudades de la frontera.
If I had the opportunity to return to the United States, I probably would return if I could do it legally, not illegally, because there's consequences to pay. I have a wife now, I have children here, I have a great job, you know, working in a call center where I can use my language skills there. I do miss my family that I still have in the U.S., you know, but as I've been here, you know, growing accustomed to the culture here, you know, this is, it's part of my life also, you know, it's part of me.